With the travel restriction, I've been recently spending a lot of time at the range and thought about getting a launch monitor. After countless review, I chose the UPT Aero GST7. Even with the language barrier, the device itself is easy to use out of the box. However, due to region restriction, the setup of the Android and Windows application can be a pain. So during this tuto, I will explain how to install and use those two applications. I will also drive you through the device feature. This is what the device looks like. So on the side here, there is a micro USB connector to charge a lithium ion battery. And there is a slot also for the micro SD. I found different information about the micro SD size. The manual provided with the device says 32 GB max, but I found online that there is some information saying that the maximum is 2 GB. So my recommendation will be to try whatever you have available. And if you need to buy one, then just buy 2 GB. So let's start the device so that I can drive you through the main feature. So this is the club selection that you can change with the two arrows up and down. Here you have the head speed, the ball speed, the carry distance, and smash factor. The carry distance basically is an estimated distance because the loft and the spin are registered inside the device and are only a standard value. The second icon here is about the history, so we will go through the different shots that I registered yesterday. You have the average per club. You know, this little icon here means average. This little icon here means that you're going to go through the whole range of data. So here you can go through all of them. Maybe I can find a good one somewhere. Yes, I wanted to show you this one. So here nearby the smash factor, you have a small indicator. Only for wood, if your smash factor is above 1.4, you will see this indicator saying that it's a good shot. Okay, so power on and off, the history, the club selection. First thing that you can do is to transfer the data from the device to the micro SD by doing a long press on the historic. You see here the square all moving. That means the data will be transferred. If you try again, you know, there is a sign that nothing to be transferred. There is a way also to erase all the data inside the device. To do this, you have to press at the same time, still device on, you have to press the history and the downwards key, those two keys. Okay, we have the message clear now. And if I go through the history, you see, I have no more shot in the history. Okay, another combo setting is about the flight distance coefficient. So for this, you need to turn off the device. Then you have to press at the same time the two arrows and turn the device on. Okay, this gives you access to the flight coefficient. Basically, you can change the coefficient for each club. And then you reduce maybe by 10%. You know, you reduce your flight sequence. And once it's done, you just turn off. There is a way to reset this distance coefficient. Just press historic, then on. Okay, that's it. I will turn it off. Then let's go back to the management of the coefficient and now the driver is back to 100. The next two combos are about the Bluetooth, to turn the Bluetooth on and to turn the Bluetooth off. And we will do this when we will review how to pair the device with the phone. Now that you have downloaded the application to your phone, you just locate the application and then you install it. There we go. To clear the Bluetooth connection, just press Historic and up arrow. Bluetooth clear. Turn the device off. Then turn it on again, but first press on the up arrow. It will initiate the pairing. The light is turning blue. Okay, so now I launch the application. I accept the pairing. Okay, so now the pairing is done. So I'm gonna drive you through the app very quickly. Head speed, ball speed, smash factor, carry distance, by club or by date. Here we have only one day. This is you have access to basic settings. So the first one is about the flight coefficient. So you can change here the flight coefficient directly. Or you can reset them all to the default value, which is 100%. The second one is about clearing the history. So there is a 99 shot registered in this application. This is to clear them all, and this is just to come back. So I don't want to clear my history, so I just come back. And the last one, I never use it, but there is a couple of selection regarding the color of the screen. So this means no indication. This means this is about the smash factor when you reach 1.4 using your wood. And this is about reaching the target distance. For example, here I want to reach, let's say, 150. This is practice mode. You can choose the color here that you want the screen to flash. And this is the time this color gonna stay on the screen for 3, 5, or 8 seconds. So first download the application to your desktop, then you can click on it. Next, give the name of your choice, organization, you can leave this blank. Next, install. Need to launch the README file, it's all in Japanese. Finish. Okay, so now you should have this icon. If for any reason you get this message here, it's because the setting of your PC is not compatible with the setup of a Japanese application. So in that case, just go to the Start, type Control Panel, go to Clock and Region, Region, Administrative. My current setting is Japanese, and this is why the program is installing without any problem. Just in case you have something different, change system local and change from whatever your setting is to Japanese. Okay, then you will need to restart your PC and then try again to install the program. Once this is done, click on the icon. There is 5 different icon, I will drive you through those. So this is the help file, all in Japanese. So I will have an English version for you. Just look in the description for the link for the download. Setting, you have only a limited setting available. It's basically the location of the folder where the data coming from the device are uploaded. The second tab is simply some information about the program itself. Okay, cancel. and reset to default, which is actually this this folder. Edit. Okay, this icon here is to import the data from the micro SD card to the folder that we have just seen previously. So click on this. Here you have an option to delete the data after the upload is completed, and I recommend you leave this checked so you don't upload twice the same data. Yes, I want to upload. Locate the position of the micro SD card. Okay, and it's done. Okay, so this is the application itself. So you have here head speed, ball speed, smash factor, and carry distance. You have the date here that you can change if you want. This is 1 day, 1 week, 1 month, all the data and the selected period. So you can choose the date you want. So I will say all. You have here the club with the maximum, average, and the minimum value by club or by date, the average, maximum, and the minimum. Okay, by date, so same. You have one more icon here for the ball speed. That's image. This is the maximum, average, and the minimum. For the smash factor, again, you have also an image. This is to give you a graphic representation how far you are from the perfect smash factor. If your points are located within the center of the club here, it means that you have a high smash factor, and further from the center, the lower your smash factor. Of course, this has nothing to do with the actual impact of the ball on the club face. This is just a graphic representation. And finally, the carry distance. So we see here that we have some data that are mishit, that are basically polluting the graph. So that gives us an opportunity to go to the edit section. So you have here change the date, delete, open file, save file, and exit. So I'm gonna open the file. Okay, this is the second day, so I have about 64 data here. This is just incremental number, again, head speed, ball speed, carry distance, smash factor, club, date, and hour and minutes, and tempo. Okay, there is obviously no data recorded in here. So the first thing I'm going to do is try to locate those records that are a little bit that are mishit. So to do that, I go to the carry distance, and by clicking on the header, you can reorganize the data ascending or descending. So obviously, those four data here are mishit. So I will erase them. Erase. Okay, done. Then if I wanted to change, let's say, the date on some of the data, because, for example, maybe those 10 shots were not actually recorded on the 21st, but let's say on 20, so I just select them, change the date, go to the calendar, and click on the 20s, which I'm not going to do now. Cancel. Okay, once all the change you wanted to make are completed, just save. Okay, save, and I'm just gonna overwrite the file and then exit. Yeah, we can see now that all the mishit have been removed from the graph. And that's it. Enjoy.